हेलो स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 6, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन ट्यूटोरियल क्लासेस फॉर विद्या भवन हाई सेकेंडरी स्कूल। दिस वीडियो इज फॉर क्लास 6 फिजिकल साइंस एंड द चैप्टर दैट आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू इज द वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट। दिस वीडियो इज पार्ट 6 फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी आर डिस्कसिंग फॉर द लास्ट 2-3 वीडियोज वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट्स इन डिटेल। In the previous video, we learned about the classification based on chemical nature and the classification based on physical nature. In this video, we are going to learn about the classification based on degradable ability. So, according to the degradational ability, the waste products can be of two types. One is biodegradable waste, and the second is non-biodegradable waste. Okay, so the biodegradable means that can be degradable by the natural way, okay, or some of the chemicals where you can say that it can be degradable, it can be mixed with the nature, it can be produce a new substances, okay. And non-biodegradable means just the opposite of it. So let's check what is it. So here, students, you can see that it is a picture where all the waste products are present, like plastic bags, like bottles, like some fruits, unused toothbrush, everything. So it includes the degradable and biodegradable products together. So on the basis of the waste products can be classified on the new term like biodegradability. And there are two types: non-biodegradable waste products and biodegradable waste products. So let's learn what is the non-biodegradable waste products. So here, non-biodegradable is an object that cannot be decomposed into organic and environmentally safe waste products. This is unlike biodegradable objects, which can easily be decomposed by soil bacteria into organic and safe waste materials. So this waste products cannot be recycled by the normal microbial degenerational process. It includes mainly, you can see that, plastic, heavy metals, etc. So the next is the biodegradable products. So what are the biodegradable products? Like, biodegradable materials can be decomposed by microorganisms such as bacteria, enzymes, fungi, etc. So biodegradable waste products are the materials that include in the household products, which may be vegetable or cooked food materials. They can be easily degenerated by the microbes, and also includes the agricultural waste products. So in the previous videos, we have already learned about many kind of the agricultural waste products, like household waste products, and sometimes we learn about the some solid waste products like plastics, bottles. These sometimes that can be non-biodegradable also. So let's check some pictures of it. So this is the picture. It is actually the agricultural waste, or you can see this in the outside of a market. So these all are biodegradable products. Like, the bacteria or the microorganisms can be degrade them easily into the soil. So if we use them after the degradation as the compost materials for using for the planting and etc. This can be very helpful because it have the nitrogenous waste products and it is very nutritious for the plants also. So the next picture that we can see, it is a picture of the non-biodegradable thing. That it includes the mainly plastic bottles, plastics, normal plastics, plastic drums, sometimes bottles, heavy metals. Many things are including in this picture. So these all products are non-biodegradable. That means the normal microbial degradational process are not done by this, because it can stay for 1,000 to 1,000 years in the earth, but they can't be degraded by the microbes because of their nature. Their chemical nature is like that they can't be degraded in the soil. So for that, for the taking out the all materials out, or taking out the materials and proper functioning of these waste materials, some people have done something that let's check. So here you can see there are 5 tubs. One is red, one is black, one is green, one is blue, and one is yellow. And the pictures are also attached with them, and they all are used for the recycling of the waste products. So the left one is for the cans, like for the metal cans. So when we have to throw a metal can, we have to drop it on this red part that can be recycled, because after taking out the waste, after jog down of the waste, there are many they have to take and check everything out from the dump, and then only it can be recycled. So if we keep it, or if we drop it like this way, then it is very much easier to recycle. So the first is for the metals, the red one. The second is the black one, is for the organic. You can see the apple picture is given. That means any vegetable peel or the banana peel or any organic thing, you can drop it on this box, on this tub. The third one is for the glasses, like any glass bottle, any broken glass, you can drop it on here. It can be recycled. The fourth one is for the paper. It is usually blue, and it is help for the dump papers, the unused papers, and out of use papers. You can drop it and it can be recycled. The fifth one is for the mainly plastics. That is the most important part and most non-biodegradable part, non-biodegradable waste. So when we are using in the plastic bottles and everything, that we can drop it on this box, and it is using for the recycle process. Those can be recycled. The procedure will be happened with them if we drop those materials according to the color, according to the pictures. So students, you check those pictures and I think you learn about them. In the next video, we are going to discuss about the waste management. That means how we can process the waste products by different kind of the manner. Till then, thank you.